Welcome back to the WDSU News Hot Seat. I'm Norman Robinson. Do you know someone who's recovering from alcohol and or drug addiction? Chances are you do. It's estimated that half of us, that's right, one out of every two Americans know someone who is fighting to stay sober. Once again, we're speaking with Mary Lou McCall and Terry Smith about next Saturday's Walk for Recovery. What is the Walk for Recovery all about, and why should we care?
The Walk for Recovery is actually, we're doing it in part with the rest of the country, SAMHSA, the Substance Abuse and Mental Health Service Association of the United States government, asked us to have recovery celebrations in the month of September. We're actually the kickoff to that month, August 25th this year. Next year, we hope to be in the middle of September itself. But they do these walks all over the country. I mean, 19,000 people walk in the city of Philadelphia. This is our first ever walk, but it's to celebrate recovery. We do work on coalitions, and we advise on different policies, and we are always talking about the problem. This is to celebrate there is a solution. This is a disease that has a solution.
So how come it's taken us this long to get around to this event?
Well, you know, there are probably weak prevention efforts in the city of New Orleans, to be honest with you.
Weak, as in W-E-A-K.
W-E-A-K. And so Terry and I are working really hard to strengthen those efforts. And as she said, this walk is so important to our community. It's not just for the people who are in recovery. It's not just for the families who are in recovery, because this is a family disease. It's for the entire community. This is our way out of the bottom. You know, we have to care, because when people are drinking and drugging, when there's violence in the street because people are trying to get money to buy drugs, it affects everyone. So we want to come out and show the positive side to recovery. It really works. Together, if we stand strong, we can do this together. We can unify. We can educate the public. And you want to know how to help the public officials to get behind this? Well, if you galvanize the public, and we want to galvanize the public, if you galvanize the public, and if we get out there as activists and show we really care, we demand change, you'll get your policymakers behind
you. What day and what time, Terry?
It is Saturday, August 25th, 9 o'clock a.m. We have some pre-walk activities that start at 8 a.m. It's Audubon Park, Shelter 10. It's their large shelter. I'm hoping this is where we're starting, and it is the first ever event for us in the city of New Orleans, but I hope we end up years from now competing with Philadelphia, walking straight down Canal Street with about 20,000 people, so we understand that this is a disease that has a recovery. You know, I've been diagnosed with a disease that's recovery is chemotherapy and a bunch of other things. This disease has its own unique recovery, and it needs to be celebrated. Those people are out there living amongst us, and we need them to walk. We really do need them to walk and to show people a way out.
What is the face of this particular problem that we're talking about? I mean, you see people being marched to you know, to central lockup and handcuffs.
Right.
Those are
right.
The stereotypical faces of drug addiction.
What's the face? This is the face of recovery. You know, several years into recovery, and it was not a pretty sight when I fell into it. And I was ashamed. I was humiliated. I didn't want this. I fought it because of the stigma attached. The face of recovery is one, a better face than even before. I mean, I was pretty prominent before I fell into alcoholism, and I did a good job and I had a great job, but I'm a better person now, because so many times we look at it as the criminal on the street or some drunk underneath a bridge. It's not that at all. It is a brain disease, and if you marshal your free will and you get treatment and you get support and your family gets behind you, you can blossom, and our city can blossom from this. You know, this affects every single person out there. There are fabulous people in recovery, and you can stay in it.
You know, this medical study that was done by the British Medical Journal talked about the harmful societal impact. Are we talking about middle and upper middle class people?
I think we are in a lot of ways. I think the face of this disease is the face of your city. I mean, it looks just like across the board. We all look. But in a lot of ways, yes, and I always think it's interesting that we keep referring to a British study, because we'll always hear, especially youth, tell us, you know, Europe doesn't have this problem. They,
they
allow drinking.
Do, yeah.
Of course they do. And they have, in London, there are huge signs that say the drinking age is 21. So that's just the face of this disease is the face of humanity. It looks like all of us.
And it's a health issue. It's a health issue. You know, it begins sometimes with anxiety, it begins with depression, and then people turn to something to self-medicate. So it affects everyone, and before you know it, you're caught up in it. People you would least expect. Well, but there is recovery, and we're going to show that August 25th
August
at Audubon
25th,
Park.
Starting at Audubon Park, shelter.
Shelter 10, the walk begins at 9, and the festivities at 8.
Okay, Terry Smith, Mary Lou McCall, thank you for
being
here.
Thank you, Norman. Thank you very much.
Good luck on your
thank
walk.
Thank you very thank much. You.
That's all the time we have. Thanks to my guests, and of course, as always, thanks to you for watching. Now let's head back over to the news desk.
Once again, the Walk for Recovery is next Saturday, August 25th, starting at 8 a.m. at Audubon Park Shelter Number 10. You can register online at www.walkforrecovery.org. It's going to be a lot of fun for a very worthwhile cause, as you just heard.